in a round he had to have, John Ruiz landed 3 out of 43 punches. Roy Jones danced around, landed 9 of 23 on his own, and closed out the near shutout on the Harold Lederman card. Mackie Shillstone, the man who helped condition Sphinx for his conquest of Holmes, was here to work with Roy Jones for this fight, and appears once again to be celebrating victory. And the tumult has calmed down in Ruiz's corner. George, we've always known Roy Jones was a great fighter. Is he even better than you thought?
That's why I wanted to make sure that we garnish this man with the pride and dignity that he deserved. He stepped up to the bat, and he got a win here tonight. Before the whole world, he showed that being small doesn't mean anything. And I mean, he's the heavyweight champion of the world. No one can take that away from him.
Well,
if he wins, we still got the judges to see.
Oh, I know.
You never know.
George, that would be...
Yeah, I've seen worse. Floyd Patterson and Jimmy
Ellis. The only one I've ever seen that might have been worse was Shannon Briggs getting a decision over you in Atlantic City.
But that
in a fight in which I think you won 10 rounds. But I don't think that's going to happen here. Let's go to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, the judges are in agreement. We have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, Jerry Roth scores the bout 116 to 112. Dwayne Ford scores the bout 117 to 111. Judge Stanley Christodoulou sees the bout 118 to 110. All three in favor of the winner, joining boxing's elite, the new WBA heavyweight champion of the world, Roy Jones Jr.
Roy Jones loves title belts. He has collected as many or more than any other current fighter, and he's got another belt now, and I got a hunch this is going to be his favorite one. Final CompuBox numbers, an economical fight, not a lot of punches thrown. Jones throwing more and landing more overall, or actually throwing fewer and landing more, as Ruiz overtook him in those last few rounds in the punches thrown category. Jabs. And when have you ever seen Roy Jones throw 220 jabs in a fight?
The battle of the jab.
And land 57. And George, I don't want to take credit, but I told you early in the fight, it looks like tonight he's chosen the jab.
You're right. But all great heavyweight champions had a good jab.
And Larry Merchant stands by with the winner.
Thank you very much, Jim. And congratulations, Roy. You went into this fight saying you had doubt. When did that doubt go away?
Let me tell you something. First of all, I have to take this time out to thank God for blessing me, for giving this vision so many years ago, actually, and just putting it in me, man, to come out and show what God can do through you if you only believe. That's what took the doubt away. I knew God planned this for me. I've been knowing God had this plan for me. I just didn't know how it would happen, when it would happen, where it would happen, but I knew God had a plan for me.
When you went into the ring, the bell rings, you're going out there, you're facing the biggest man you've ever faced. What concerned you at that moment?
Just the fact that I don't walk into a big punch early, because I've never been hit in 10-ounce gloves by a heavyweight. So my dad very well prepared me for this. Merck did a wonderful job. Mackie Shillstone did a hell of a job. We all came together as a team. Pensacola in the house!
So you're saying your first concern was don't get hit by a big sucker punch.
Yeah, don't get caught by something while I'm asleep. Hey, soften the prisoners. I'll be able to get y'all to soften the prisoner, baby. I'm coming at y'all at Pensacola. Yeah.
And then,
Mobile, baby.
And then it looked
Gulf Coast.
Like virtually all of your fights. A guy comes to you, hit him, and he stops coming.
I told you I was jump on weak. I came out there. I knew he thought I was going to run. You didn't see him running. You just saw some more boxing. I didn't run. I boxed. That's what I do for a living. And like I said, until somebody beat Roy Jones, I'm not changing. That's what I am. That's who I am. I'm Roy Jones. MJ, what's up, baby? I'm looking for you to get your fit there. Mobile Rebels, I'm coming back, baby.
How early, I should say, did you feel this fight is mine.
Well, I felt it early, but you got to remember, a heavyweight is a big puncher. I took the fight out of him. I think I had him really quick, but I wasn't going to take any stupid chances because that's my career. And that's been a...
When you say you think you had him quit, that is when he stopped going forward and stopped standing in the middle of the ring with you, you knew you had him.
I had him. And the reason he stopped, because he was getting popped with some good shots. Hey, quit pushing me, man. What? So, this is my 14th anniversary for professional boxing, so, you know, this is a wonderful surprise for me.
Pretty good way to celebrate. All right. Throughout your boxing career, we've seldom seen you throw your jab with this kind of vehemence and confidence. What was there about this fight that led you to do that?
Well, John is front foot heavy, meaning he keeps all the weight on his front foot. So when he does this, it allows me to get my jab off and keep him offset. So what I did was I watched the tape again last night, and I said, you know what? Kirk Johnson could have boxed him with a jab and killed him. Kirk didn't do that. Kirk let up and kept trying to go to the body. I stayed away from his body. So I boxed him with my jab, and I was like, you know, as long as he front foot heavy like that, there's no way he can get out the way of my jab. So I just like to thank everybody at Square Ring, Eminem Sports, Fred Levin, Marab Muhammad, Stanley Levin, Linda Padgett,
what does
my whole team.
What does this mean to
but
you
God
now?
God does it all. This means that I am pound for pound the baddest mother. You know what? I'm going to touch a pair of boxing gloves. I don't care what nobody say. Larry Merchant, anybody, I am the baddest. They can say what they want to say. How many times have a man started as a junior middleweight and became the heavyweight champion of the world? It don't happen. Only Ali can shock the world like I did. Huh?
Not middleweight.
Let's look ahead for a bit. There seems to be two logical opponents out there. Give us your thought. One might be as a heavyweight. One might be Evander Holyfield. You once traveled to Atlanta to check him out to see if he wanted to fight you. He didn't seem to at that time. Now that you have a belt, he might want to. What is your feeling?
Well, I mean, I like Evander. Evander's a great fighter. However, for me to beat Evander at this time in his career would not mean anything to me. He's older than I am. He's on his way out. John beat him two times. I beat John. If I beat him, what are they going to say? Nothing. So it's not really a big issue to me. I didn't want to do this to become a legitimate heavyweight. I just wanted one fight. So I have to see what's on the table for me. If something's beautiful, I mean, if they give me, offer me something that's totally undeniable, then maybe, I don't know. But I got to see what's happening. I don't know yet.
Chris Bird.
I did this to make history.
Chris Bird, who also, like you, was a middleweight, started a little bigger than you. He's got a title. Your thoughts about fighting him someday to unify two titles?
Chris Bird's a friend of mine. Chris Bird's a great fighter. He's a great southpaw fighter. I take my hat off to him. He's been in the heavyweight division a lot longer than myself. You know, if it's good for the public and if it's good money, I mean, why not? But if it's not really big money, no, I'm not going to do that because, you know, I like Chris. I got a lot of admiration. Chris is the one who really, really actually helped inspire me to go ahead and come up and do this.
So to interpret what you're saying if there is some extraordinary money on the table, you would have to seriously consider defending your title as a heavyweight.
I honestly have to look at it. I can't say I wouldn't. That's only right, you know what I mean? So, you know.
Congratulations on a great night, Roy.
HBO Pensacola in the house!
Jim! All right, thank you very much, Larry. Meanwhile, we show you a shot of John Ruiz, who bolted from the ring and went straight to his dressing room. We're now going to send Larry back there to see if Larry can get into the dressing room and get a conversation with John Ruiz. And I repeat, Roy Jones is one of the four or five smartest people you'll ever meet in your whole life. Now, what an opportunity he's got, George, because Chris Bird has that other title belt. Roy Jones, if he fought and beat Chris Bird, could have two-thirds of the heavyweight championship.
You know, I like to say congratulations to HBO. The youngest man to ever become heavyweight champion of the world, Mike Tyson. The oldest, you know who that is. And then for this guy to elevate and become heavyweight champion of the world on the network, this is wonderful. Pay-per-view, although this is, I'm really watching history. I've loved every moment of it.
Shouldn't he fight Bird? I mean,
I think he should fight Lennox Lewis.
You think he could fight Lennox Lewis?
I think he could do it. He's proven to me. He's gone 12 rounds. The cat is out of the bag. Every little guy, Allen Iverson.
Now, that's a whole, now you that's can a put, whole different deal.
I no, mean, Lewis, it's not a different
Lewis
deal.
Lewis weighs 25 pounds more than does John Ruiz.
Yeah, he's but when you saw Allen Iverson go up and dunk against those guys, he's added credibility to what small, short guys can do.
Allen Iverson no longer doesn't get punched in the mouth when he dunks.
Yeah, they punch him in the mouth. But Roy Jones Jr. is the legitimate heavyweight champ of the world. I would like to see him fight one of those big guys. They can't do any more to him than what John Ruiz did tonight. He's there now.
I think the opportunity is to fight Chris Bird, who only outweighs him by about 15 pounds, and whose style, it seems to me, would make for an interesting fight.
Don't downgrade the guy. Go for the big guy. Let him fight Lennox Lewis. He did tonight. He's proven to me he can go 12 rounds.
Fight Lennox Lewis. I just can't imagine that he's going to take. I mean, this to me, I always said, if Roy Jones thought this was a risk, he wouldn't have done it. Roy Jones doesn't like risks. Fighting Lewis is a risk.
A risk of what?
A risk of your health, because he's so much bigger than Ruiz and a bigger hitter.
We said that tonight about John Ruiz.
I didn't.
But a lot of people have said the extra weight. But it's congratulations. It's a wonderful night. I'm just happy to be a part of this. Royce Jones Jr. has brought a lot of class to the heavyweights now. I love it.
Well, Roy Jones Jr. is a classy guy. George Foreman, at the end of the day, will we remember this most as a fight that Jones won because Ruiz didn't really have special talents, or a fight that Jones won because he was brave, daring, and creative?
I'm not going to discredit either one of those guys. I think the Ruiz is a wonderful heavyweight. He's this guy, he just couldn't hit what he couldn't see. From this point on, Jim, I'm going to even be afraid of you. I've got the height advantage, but that doesn't mean anything around you anymore.
George, that's the first lie you've told to the public.
I'm afraid of you. I think you can get me.
All right, let's go to Larry Merchant right now.